this holds it.
It's fine, perfect.
What happens if you move over to your right a wee bit more? Okay.
Alright.
Yeah. Alright, time's up.
For the last few years, Scottish artist Mark Gilbert has been living in Omaha, crafting portraits of patients and caregivers at the University of Nebraska Medical Center.
I was scared rigid when it started, and I still am nervous as I carry on, especially when I meet somebody for the first time.
It's all part of a unique multi-year project exploring the connections between art and medicine.
I'd had this idea that we could use art to help us learn about care. Sometimes we talk about it in really complicated ways in the health professions, and I thought maybe art would help us scale down the way we thought about it.
Many patients are survivors of head and neck cancer.
So just try and be as honest as possible and just kind of react to who's in front of you or what's in front of you. And so working with Jason, he's just really easy going.
In 1995, at the age of 22, doctors found a cancerous tumor behind Jason Shue's nose. 12 surgeries later, Jason now works in the University Medical Center's Head and Neck Cancer Center, assisting other cancer patients.
He's a really interesting guy. The things he's been through and the way that he deals with it is fascinating.
Same room you were in earlier.
You don't think about them when you're making the picture, but all these things, they still matter. The picture will be richer because of that relationship. Many of the patients feel as if they're kind of giving something back by sitting for the pictures, that they're raising awareness.
He's not gonna do a fake portrait. This is who I am, this is how it is, this is what we gotta show for like the other 30,000 head and neck patients that are out there. And still hope in others. Don't give up.
I never tried to flatter anybody, but I don't think I could even if I tried, really. I think the paintings can be quite harsh, you know, and I've known I've upset people in the past. I'd be working with people who didn't like looking in the mirror, didn't like looking at photographs, and yet they were going to let an artist interpret how they looked. You know, I'm in a very privileged situation to be able to work with these people during the most traumatic moments of their lives.
The patients are gaining a sense of resolution as their portrait is reflected back at them. What they had thought they looked like was actually quite different than what Mark reflected in the portrait.
You can see the sadness in the eyes, I think. It makes me happy to think that I have come as far as I have.
With a total of 100 paintings, drawings, and prints of caregivers and patients at every stage of the wellness spectrum, the Medical Center hopes to arrange a national or international tour of the collection. But it is this initial exhibition at the Bemis Center in Omaha that allows the participants and their family members to see the totality of the work for the very first time.
The eyes are a big key in all his portraits. You can really catch, like really the patients, what they feel or possibly what they've gone through.
Everybody's happy.
We are.
When the Medical Center approached Steve and his sister Glenna to participate in the project, he was dead set against the idea.
My first thought was, you have to be kidding. Here my sister is laying in bed, just out of surgery, cancer surgery, or her jaw removed, and she's thinking about a portrait. And I'm going, this is insane.
I guess you know better.
I got to the point where I didn't even want to look in the mirror. I just didn't want to. But when I saw that portrait, it was like, you know, this isn't really as bad as you think it is. Here's a survivor. You're beautiful. Every time I would go to see Mark, I would feel better about it.
For Betsy Lomax, surgery to reduce the size of her stomach helped her win her battle with obesity and lose 150 pounds. But despite feedback from friends and family, she couldn't see just how much her appearance had changed.
People would say, gosh, you look so different. And I think, where?
I mean, how? Because I would actually stand in front of the mirror and just stare at myself, and I wouldn't see any difference. And then when I saw the portrait that he was working on, I looked at that and I thought, who is that? And then I thought, well, that's me. I thought, wow, there is a difference, there is a change. Never felt pretty before, felt big before. And when I looked at that, I thought, that's pretty. And it made me feel pretty. It was terrific.
Which was something we had no idea would come out of this. But
there were a lot of unknowns when the project started in 2006. The initial idea was to examine portraits of patients and caregivers to learn about the subtle dimensions of healthcare. 4 years later, the researchers have published a paper detailing the results of this unusual medical study, and what they found astounds them.
I think the first thing that we really noticed about those portraits was that they were very introspective, whether they were the patients or the caregivers. They just sort of pull you into the experience of the subject. And the person is a whole person, not a heart or a liver or a tumor or a pregnancy.
I think they saw a beauty or a strength or a quality that they didn't feel that other people necessarily saw. When they looked at the painting or the drawing, they understood Mark picked that up, and if Mark picks it up, it's likely that other people are as well.
Marty and her husband Rob both took part in the Portraits of Care project. Rob was undergoing treatment for cancer, and Marty was his primary caregiver. 2 years later, they are shocked by what the portrait revealed.
Rob looked at that portrait and he said, you know, in you I see a vulnerability and almost a waifishness. And I had been the strong one through all of this, you know. I thought, no. And I looked at it. There it is. There it is. And when I looked at him, I thought, huh, I still see the same person. But I saw an acceptance of the new normal. It was just amazing that Mark perceived all of that.
The medical study seemed a bit odd at first to Dolores Poulin, who is a registered nurse. But both she and her late husband, Roger, agreed to take part. Roger had ALS and had lost the ability to speak. The experience had a big impact on them both.
I didn't expect the emotion that I would feel when I saw the portraits. I was in a different place. And just the emotion, maybe so much in his eyes. His eyes were the first thing that ever attracted to me too, to begin with. And he communicated so much with his eyes when he couldn't, you know, communicate verbally. Even though Roger couldn't talk to Mark, they had this relationship that was powerful.
I think the result of the exhibition was to help people maybe realize a wee bit more that it's kind of all part of life. It's emotional, but somehow it's not as bad.
For Mark Gilbert, artists and doctors have a lot in common. So much so that now he's pursuing a PhD in art and medicine at the University of Nebraska. Both fields require keen observation skills, and both can change lives.
It did illustrate how art can enhance the understanding of everybody and how medicine and health and human condition can feed into art or any decent art.